You are absolutely beautiful. That's who you are. And I honor the Lord for you. Amen. So I just wanted to release this word. This is especially for a brother. Yes, this is for you. And it's a place where the Bible tells us in 1 Peter 5:8, it says, be sober and be vigilant for the adversary. It says your enemy, the adversary, is roaming about like a roaring lion and seeking whom to devour. And it's amazing because with you, you're walking in the dimension of holiness, and that holiness is absolutely beautiful. But you have to understand that there what? It says the enemy goes about trying to dig a pit, but it says they will fall into it themselves. The wicked, they dig a pit, but they will fall into it themselves. And this is just how I want to basically bring this word of encouragement to you. I remember there was a time I was at the university. Yes, I was. And, you know, I believe I just probably came back from a lecture. But there was this particular individual, and the person, you know, she said to me, I want to come and visit you because we've just finished college and I've moved into university. And I believe she went to another university. And then she said she just wanted to come and visit me because it was myself and one other friend that we were together in that university. Yeah, we were together. And she decided to come. She wanted to come and pay a visit. So I said, yeah, that's fine, that this is the time we actually finish lectures. So it will be good for you to meet me at this particular time, you know, in my halls of accommodation. So she eventually turned up. Yes, she did. And I was basically trying to sort my assignment out. But the agenda that she had was totally different. Yes, it was. Because it was a place I was trying to get myself ready, and I was basically trying to get something to eat at the same time. And in the midst of all of that, you know, I eventually just found her naked, and she was on the bed. And she was there, and she was like, you know, I'm here, I'm naked, you know, are you just going to stand there and watch, you know, watch me? And I said, no, I don't think it's something I want to do. And I basically began to tell her, you need to get dressed, you know, you need to really get dressed. So in that moment in time, after like a few minutes of, you know, persuasion, I told her, you know, you need to get dressed because it's not right at all. You know, in that moment, it's not right. And eventually she hearkened to that in itself and she got dressed. We continued the conversation and, you know, that was the end of it. And she eventually left. Can you see that in itself? So it's a place I just wanted to encourage a brother out there that you have been walking in the holiness of the Father, but this is what the enemy is trying to do with you, to dig a pit so that you might fall into the dimension of what? Fornication. That's basically the word. Yes, he wants to lead you, you know, into fornication. And the Lord is saying, flee from what? From fornication. But I thank God because it says whatever is hidden in the dark, it brings it into what? Into light. And this is a revelation that is releasing to you. It says, be careful of what? Of female visitors in this hour. I'm not saying don't accept invitations and things like that. I'm not saying don't. That's not my counsel. My counsel is be careful. Can you see that? Don't be afraid, because the Bible says that what? The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom. And it says he has not given you the spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of sound mind. Can you see? Because this person, they asked to come and visit innocently, but something has eventually happened. So it was a, you know, she was trying to, it was just a setup. So I wanted to just bring that, because the person might have good intentions, but the enemy can take advantage of that moment. Because you know why? There are some times that some blessings are about to appear for you or to you. And in that in itself, it can send a distraction. So if you basically fall for the distraction, it's a way of you can miss the blessing that he intends to give you. Can you see that? So that's why he's encouraging in this hour, be very careful of what? Of female visitors. Can you see? So, like I always say, trust in the Lord and lean not on your own understanding. And the Bible tells us, woe is the one who trusts in man. So you have to be what? You have to be sober and you have to be vigilant. And, you know, just love and appreciate and just, you know, whatever the Lord is instructing you to do, just do that in itself. So it's a place that counsel is coming. Flee from fornication. That was the trap that they tried to set for me, but the Lord granted me the grace to overcome that and flee from it. Do you see that in itself? So I just want to release that to you, you know, in this dimension, in Jesus' name. And I just want to surround you also with the wall of fire, and I bless you with the mercy of God. Amen and amen. God bless you.